This Headless Professor video is about a measure of dispersion known as the standard deviation. Sometimes it's abbreviated this way, or just with two letters, or even with one letter S. Sometimes you'll even see this Greek letter, little sigma, but that really refers to a population standard deviation. What we're going to be working with in this class is the standard deviation we calculate on a smaller data set, such as a sample or even a smaller group within a sample. Now I'm going to show you an equation for calculating standard deviation, and I want you to trust me. This equation looks scary, but it's the easiest equation you can use for calculating standard deviation. Here it is. Now I'm not going to explain it in words as a whole, because that sounds pretty scary too. What I'm going to do is to explain the individual components of this equation, because once we understand them, it's not such a scary equation. So there was that square root sign. We know what that means. And what's going to appear under that square root sign is going to be something known as the variance. And what we're going to do is we're going to square root that, and that is our standard deviation. Now, the equation that we started out with has the letter N here, here, and here. Well, that simply means the number of cases. How many subjects or participants are we getting data from? The other thing we see on this particular equation is X here and here. And X simply means one score, a score from a particular person or case. The other thing, and that's probably the most scary, is this Greek letter right here. That's a capital sigma. It simply means the sum of a series. Well, now that we know what each of those components stands for, we can take some numbers, and we can actually do some calculations. Let's take a data set. We're going to look at the case, the score, and the square of that score. We have five cases, so our N is 5. We've got that already. Now we're going to look at the individual scores, 8, 8, 9, 4, 7. Notice that they don't have to be in any particular order, ascending or descending. And if we added all those up, that would be the sum of all the scores. Now we're going to take each score and we're going to square it. 8 becomes 64, 9 becomes 81, 4 becomes 16, 7 becomes 49, and we're going to add up the sum of all of those squares of the scores. Now, let's look at some of our real numbers. The N is 5. So now we're actually able to get the denominator of this equation. The denominator is going to be 5 times 4, or 20. So we know the denominator. One good trick in calculation is to store the denominator in the calculator memory. Then go ahead and get the numerator, then divide by the denominator. And that's what I hope we're going to do here. Now we add up the sum of all the scores, and we get a 36. If we were to square that 36, that would give us what this looks like. That's 1,296. The other thing we need to make this equation work is the sum of all the individual squares. That's 274. So we take this equation and let's plug in the numbers that we have here. We've already calculated our denominator of 20. Now let's work on the numerator. Let's take 5 times 274. Well, that's 1370. Now let's take the 1370 minus 1296. That is going to be 74. Now we have 74 over 20. That's 3.7. Now this thing that we see right here, the 3.7, that's known as the variance. That's not the end of our calculation. We're going to take that variance and we're going to square root it, and that's going to be our answer. The standard deviation is 1.9. We usually round off to one decimal place more than where our score's from. Our scores came from whole numbers, so we'll usually go to the tenths place on this. Now we're going to do a little bit of error checking just to make sure that our standard deviation number is reasonable. And one of my rules of thumbs is that we need to get the range on this. Well, our top score was 9, our bottom score, our lowest score was 4, and so we had a range of 5. And this is one of my rules for error checking, that the standard deviation usually lies between the range and the interquartile range. So we have a range of 5, we have a standard deviation of 1.9. Yes, that's going to make sense, because usually the standard deviation is going to be less than half of the range. So we have our answer. We know what our standard deviation is, in this case, 1.9. We followed the formula. But I want you to trust me on one other thing when it comes to calculating standard deviation in the real world, and that is, don't use the formula. Use Excel, SPSS, Staccato, or some other spreadsheet program. It's just a lot easier.